I don't know. I feel like it's my fault that we're not as close as we used to be.
It's not your fault. It's my fault. I'm not doing everything I'm supposed to do. Is it too late?
I don't know.
You know, baby, I just want to tell you how sorry I am for being so cold. It's not like I don't like being married. It's just that sometimes I feel like the walls are closing in on me.
Now, hold on 1 minute. Whatever you did to yourself. Because I've been running around here trying to make a nice life for us, taking care of the kids, being every woman. But lately, you deserve so cold.
Oh,
grow up.
You know it's true.
Look, I know none of this is easy, but I miss us. I miss what we had. I miss it to the core, and I just need to know how come we don't care anymore?
You the one on strike.
It's been a mighty long time.
You out of your mind.
Yep.
Baby, I still want you, and I've wanted you for so long. But every time I touch you, you act like I did something wrong. Yes, you do. I don't want to leave.
Neither do I.
I still want you.
I'm going to cry.
Where are the kids?
I told you they're gone.
In that case, we should be making love.
I told Nikki that my life wasn't about what I wanted. I lied. I'm not that unselfish. I know exactly what I want. I want a woman that will not only fight with me, but who will fight for me. A woman I can go to war with who will drag me and my kids out alive. A woman that can see the good in me when I can't even see it in myself. You know, Nikki was a great fantasy. But in reality, I think I love my wife.
It's Bobby Lieber, and welcome to your favorite podcast, The 11th Brick at Stonewall, because we all know a butch lesbian or a trans woman of color probably threw the first brick at Stonewall, but it was a cis white gay man who threw the 11th brick. And today, as always, I will take you on a journey throughout LGBTQ plus history, and much more importantly, my own problems and whatever I feel like talking about. And this is a big day, because as of today, the 11th brick is celebrating 1 million subscribers. And in honor of all this exciting news, I am taking your questions live. First question.
Hi, Bobby. Any chance for more children's books?
Oh, not at the moment, but thank you. As some of you know, I wrote a series of children's books to help parents teach kids about gay history, which no one bought. Turns out a 4-year-old didn't want to hear a bedtime story about Martina Navratilova. Hey parents, thanks for teaching your kids about Santa Claus, a straight man that doesn't exist, and not Martina Navratilova, a lesbian who does. In other news, I finally got the footage from my audition to be part of the next cast of Queer Eye, and you can watch that on the app right now.
Oh no.
Sorry, this is not sad. It's just not sad. You gave him a haircut and a pair of pants. I mean, he looks fine. Not great. Next caller.
Whatever happened to that movie you wrote?
Oh yeah, the movie. These big movie producers came to me and said, we want you to write a rom-com about a gay couple. Something the whole world would enjoy. Something that a straight guy might even like and watch with his girlfriend. I said, something a straight guy might like? Like what exactly? Am I gonna be in the middle of some high-speed chase and then all of a sudden fall in love with Ice Cube? Am I gonna get butt-fucked by Jason Momoa while we're both, I don't know, worrying about a volcano? And he said, Bobby, we just want to make a movie that shows the world gay and straight relationships are the same. Love is love is love. I said, love is love is love. No, it's not. That's bullshit. That is a lie we had to make up to convince you idiots to finally treat us fairly. Love is not love. Our relationships are different. Our sex lives are different. And he said, Bobby, We were just trying to make a nice movie about nice gay people. And I said, well, there's your first mistake, because not all gay people are nice. And I got up and left. Anyway, it's totally fine. I'm not the right person to write a rom-com anyway.
Why not?
I don't know. I mean, I'm 40 years old. I've never been in love. I've never even had a serious relationship, which is fine. You know, I love my life. I love my freedom. I love my independence. But, you know, probably means I'm not the right person to write a love story. In exciting news, I remain very horny, and tonight I am being honored at the LGBTQ+ Pride Awards.